the six very powerful qualities that each one of us should have. Even if you forget all that you've done, just remember this picnic. I don't say that you should forget. I'm saying even if you forget, please do not forget the picnic. Can I begin with the first one? The first thing you should have for you in life is passion. What is passion? A very deep understanding, a deep desire to achieve something. So what do I say to all of you? Become more passionate about your growth. Become really passionate about wanting to go to Spain and Barcelona to watch the match there. That is passion. Passion is not just thinking and having a dream. Passion is working on a dream towards realizing that dream. So please become passionate about. So if you say, Mayur, what should I become passionate about here in this session? I would say become passionate about self-improvement. Please become, have a very strong desire to keep improving upon yourself. Only then you will see the change in your life. Can I go to the next one? I always believe this is important. Inspiration is self-motivation. Why I say this? There will be occasions where you will face nervousness, you will face stress, you will face barriers. It's part of life. The point is, if you're inspired, what is inspiration? A very high level of enthusiasm, excitement, energy. If you feel that, that inspiration will help you to conquer the barriers also. Whenever we are climbing the mountain, remember when you're going up, it is difficult. Even a little mountain when you're climbing is difficult. There are slip ups. Sometimes, you know that in real mountaineering, they sometimes even have to abort that climb. They go again later. So such pitfalls may happen only if your inspiration, which means, if you say what is inspiration, when your energy is high, when you feel enthusiastic every day before going to office, when you're excited about the work that's given to you, believe me friends, that for me is your inspiration. It's when you're inspired, you will always never give up. Can you read this? What exactly should we do? Karna kya hai? Just remember these words. Always. Whenever you communicate with anyone, one person, 10 people, 100 people, in the meeting, outside the meeting, in the factory, wherever, if you want to communicate, please communicate by becoming. Can you read this word?
Loud.
Absolutely. You got to be loud. You're getting my point, Ronald? I didn't get that.
Yes, sir.
I didn't get that.
Yes, sir.
Good. And maintain this, bro. I know you're 20, but remember, you're still in 19, right? You're still an adult. And you have better potential than many of us to grow because you're the youngest probably here. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Excellent. Along with it, you also got to have this. Can you read this? Exactly. Be clear in your speech, Sandeep. Remember, you have good thoughts, I know that. You have a positive attitude, I know that. But it has to be clearly spoken. Otherwise, the other person does not understand what you're saying. If you want to be a good communicator, please be loud and have good clarity in your speech, because that will make your thoughts reach the listener in the best possible manner. Are you with me?
Yes.
I didn't hear that. Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. And believe in what I say and start practicing it. Can I go to the next one?
Yes.
Sorry, I'll use. Can you read this?
Yes.
If you want to really grow in life, please become more, like you very correctly spotted, innovative. Innovation means, at the end of the day, you know, somebody says, what is innovation? Wow, big word, simple. Become the person who has the attitude to think of new ideas. Every day, try to find out, can I think differently about this situation? There's a problem, think a little out of the box. All I say is, don't get stuck to the same thing. Think of new ideas. Think of different other ways of solving a problem. At least have the attitude to do that. Remember, when you start thinking of new ideas, it's not that every idea will be successful. But at least you tried. Are you clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Can I go to the next one?
Yes.
read this?
Initiative.
What is initiative is always have the attitude to not wait for somebody to tell you to do things. You do it on your own. Initiative means you taking your first step forward on your own rather than waiting for somebody to push you. Another word for initiative is being self-driven. Initiative means you have an idea, you say, sir, can I talk to you? You have a question, you have a doubt, you have a query, you say, sir, can I talk to you? Not wait for somebody to say, hey, you talk to the sir, no? Initiative requires a lot of passion. Initiative requires a lot of inspiration. Initiative also requires a lot of courage. Initiative means if you feel you want to do something, you do it. Of course, you have to evaluate and you have to understand whether what I'm doing is good or bad. But once you know it's good, you do it. Initiative means not waiting for things to happen, but making it happen on your own without having the fear of failure. Are you clear on what I'm saying? In a meeting, if you have something to add in the meeting, take the initiative and say, sir, can I say something? That's initiative. If the sir says, if your boss says, we need to work on a project, he doesn't tell you to do it, but he says, we need to work on that new ABC project. You take the initiative yourself, and in the next meeting, you say, sir, I have worked on a few things. The sir says, or the boss says, I didn't tell you, sir, I just thought, let me just do a little bit. Boss says, not bad, good, yeah. He realizes that without telling somebody, this guy is doing it on his own. That is initiative. Clear?
Yes.
And in life, whether it's your social life, your friends and all, your personal life, your family and stuff, and most importantly, your professional life, you cannot ignore because you need it every time and you need what is courage. Because fear, if you have fear, nothing will happen. As I said, even to take initiative, you need courage. Courage also, remember, helps you when you fail. The courage to deal with failure. The courage to say sorry is also courage. Because that's the time when the ego comes and you don't want to say sorry. If your junior does something good, the courage to appreciate is also courage. The courage to rise from the fall is also courage. So tomorrow if you fail, have the courage to say, I have failed, I am feeling down, but I will come back again. Who represents this courage the most is what I've seen is a boxer in a fight. Have you heard of the sport called boxing?
Yes.
Tell me one boxer who has not lost even one single fight. Even Mike Tyson has lost a fight. Mayweather probably is the only one, rare one, who probably has not lost. But if you look at it, 99.99% of the boxers have at least once lost a fight. Okay, let's go technically this way. Tell me one boxer who has not been punched. My point is not to have a dialogue about it. My point is that they have come back. No, that's what I'm saying. They had the courage to fight back. Sometimes you find the boxer, I've seen this particular clip. The boxer is knocked down. He's got one eye, he can't see. You know, it's like fully swollen. And the guy who's beaten him, it's a knockdown, he falls flat. It's like the seventh count, and that other fellow is already there. He's won it. That guy gets up. Because probably he's using 7 seconds to gather his strength. He gets up. They fight again. And that guy who was having the, you know, who was knocked out for some time, he knocks this guy out. Completely. That's called courage. Courage to stand up from a fall. In our case, courage to stand up from a failure. We may. Everybody's failure. But the courage to not give up is what I want to conclude this session with. My request to all of you is, take it with strength. I know I've been pretty strong, right? But at the same time, we also have had fun. I have to do a little pushing, otherwise this becomes a vanilla session. How was it? Good. Okay, fine. It has to hit you somewhere. And unless it hit you, I'm not saying physically or even at the mind level. Don't get hurt and all. Take it as a good feedback from a good brother. Because we need to have these gaps filled up. If I won't tell you to speak loud and clear, then what's the point of me coming here from India? Who need to scratch your backs and say, you're good. Of course you're good. That's why you're in this company, boss. But good isn't good when better can be expected. Don't forget that on which basis I'm losing my breath. And we've gone into tremendous depth. Are you clear?
Yes.